Hey guys, I know you thought we were done with the go-kart build, but we got one more video for you. Today we got a special guest coming. He's gonna critique our go-kart build, tell us the things we did right, some of the things we did wrong, or a lot of the things we did wrong. But before we do that, I wanted to go over some of the things that we changed on the go-kart. First things first, we kind of revamped the whole brake setup here. First thing we did was flip around the pedals to actually have them face the right direction. They were installed the wrong way. We didn't know, it was our first time. So once we got that flipped around, we actually changed how the retainer springs set up on these. Joe made some really cool posts. Now these pedals always return to center. So change that up a little bit. We also had to relocate the tabs for the gas and the brake pedal lines themselves. Before they were on the bottom of the go-kart, we just moved them to the top, super easy. And the last thing we did with them was actually move the pedals to the outside of the frame. This was totally just a preference thing. Basically, the bigger guys like me and Scott, we just had a hard time riding this. So once we moved them towards the outside, felt a little more natural, a little more normal, and made it a lot better to ride. So the last thing we really did to this was just add a floor pan. When we were test riding it, we noticed it was a little scary because our feet could dangle down and we didn't want to hurt ourselves. So we brought Scott in, he rolled some beads, added some dimple dies, and it came out great and it's really strong and it looks good. Now our special guest should be arriving here in a few minutes. Let's go find him and figure out what he has to say about this thing.
You're coming.
Yeah. Check this thing out.
That felt normal.
Did it?
No.
I'll give you something to feel.
That felt normal.
It's actually a 30 by 30 table.
Yep.
Just because of your articulating.
And you're kind of like at home, make small parts, stuff like that. And now I'm kind of like...
Now I don't have... Really, we don't have much load in here.
You can do basic shapes.
Yeah, we're going to have...
All right, guys. So Brad's in the house. Quick detour from R&D. We're now here looking at the go-kart. We're gonna have them graded on three scales. We're gonna do it on design, fabrication, and performance. So, out the gate, what do you think of the design?
It's pretty cool. I'm kind of curious where you guys came up with some of your stuff, and did you draw it up by hand, or like, what did you do there?
We pretty much referenced some photos online, stole little bits and pieces from each one that we thought looked cool, or we thought was in our wheelhouse to be able to accomplish. And really just started making one piece at a time. Start with side rails. Okay, those aren't terrible. Let's do some cross bracing.
Gotcha.
That's not terrible. How about a nose? And it just fell into place really from there.
Okay. So the first thing I noticed kind of coming in was your side rail is a little overbent on the top bend here, you know? And because of that, the motor's tilted back.
Yeah.
Okay. So it's not really a big deal. Everything's all rigid and fixed on this, so it's not like it's going to move a lot. But, you know, in kind of the realm of where I'm from with drag racing, you want to tilt everything actually forward so that when you hit the tire, it kind of gets a little bit more grip and all that kind of fun stuff. Mm. That works on kind of any car, but with this, because it's fixed axle, it's not going to play as much of a role in it. Just looks kind of goofy that it's all tilted back. It's got that gasser look to it.
That's what I was going for. That okay. Is what we were going for.
Is that
for?
What you're going for? You're like, I'm going to build a gasser go kart.
Yeah. Okay, so.
But, you know, kind of going a little bit further on with it, you know, the one thing I noticed also was you have these washers to adjust the motor. Kind of thinking forward with that, what you could do is you could have a plate that the motor sits on and it could hinge in the front with adjustment screws in the back and take your chain slack out. Because you got all this chain slack on the back side here that's kind of making it, you know, hard for you to kind of keep this tight. You don't really have a good way to do it, so you got to add some washers over and over and over again to keep the chain tight or take a link out, you know.
All right, okay. So all considered, first time designing, what would you grade the design?
I'd give you guys a B on the design, you know, especially for the fact that you basically did it on pen and paper. You didn't really have a whole lot to work with, you know. The one thing I noticed is that you have the front axle is all one piece instead of having it that, you know, you didn't make the side rail all one piece and one bend and then add these little stubs on the side and all that. So it, you know, having an axle all one piece adds a lot of strength to it.
And we did that strictly. We wanted to do as much as we can as far as one solid piece around.
Yeah.
But
it's just coincidental.
It's coincidental because then we started just subtracting, like, okay, we can probably nail two bends and not screw anything else up, let alone tube ends, that one around the back.
So when you guys did the bends, were you using like did you use the angle finder like we have done in the past with stuff?
Okay. Yep, angle finder.
Okay.
Just our handheld
the tubing handheld bender.
Okay. But and I guess even then we overbend it anyway.
Yeah. So. Well, the thing would have been if you would have tried to make it like all one tube, basically running down the side and having your nose piece involved as well and all that, you got two bends and then you would have to roll it 90, mm-hmm. do two bends and then roll it back the other way 90 and then do two more bends. You could have done it, it's just it gets complicated and, it kind of becomes a whole process. So.
All right, I'll take a B. I like it.
Okay.
Now fabrication, how did we execute on the design?
Well, you guys did pretty good with fitting everything and welding it up. Like, some of the welds are pretty good. Some of them are, looks like somebody fell asleep. This tube right here I was looking at earlier is a little out of square, but, as we kind of were talking about, these aren't really needed anymore anyways. So you could kind of cut them out if you wanted to, the whole design of it really is it works, you have a good general, setup that is solid. We talked about how the welds here on your steering are very solid. You want to be able to make sure your rack stays in there for sure. Last thing you want to do is lose steering on this thing, especially because it's so fast, according to Dave.
Yeah.
So.
And courtesy, Dave, those are some solid welds, man.
It's like, you guys did a good job fabricating it. You have a good, good amount of tools here to be able to use and everything. The one thing that, I would look at adding into it would be doing something with a roll bar.
Mm-hmm.
And even going forward and bringing something forward. That way, if you did roll it over, you're not just sitting on the roll bar here, but you have some strength above your head.
That's good.
And then when you do that, you could add harnesses in it and have yourself a set of 4 points. That way, you roll it over, and you're not getting chucked out of it at the same time.
Yeah, when this thing gets the speed.
Right. Well, right now, the thing is, you kind of have a double-edged sword. So if you put harnesses on it now, you're only going to put basically a lap belt on it. And if you roll it over, you're probably better off getting chucked away from it than you are being in it. But if you have a full cage on it, and you roll it over, you're going to be a lot safer.
Excellent. Now, I guess, what would you grade that? What would you grade the fabrication?
The fabrication, I would still give you guys a B on it,
All right, so we're averaging a B right now.
Yeah, I'd say you did a pretty good job with it. You guys have a good general idea on what's going on with welding and everything. A couple of the welds you had to grind away, I see, but, it's more for aesthetics than anything else.
That's right. All right, I guess down to performance. General performance meaning, motor orientation, how we did the steering, that kind of.
As far as performance goes, it looks like you got a good visual off of Google on what, you needed to do and all that kind of stuff. So even the way that the steering is set up with the pinion angle, the kingpin angle, which is, the tilt back that you have here on the pin itself. That's what makes it kind of more sturdy when you're going down the road and not darting all over the place and such.
That was courtesy of Cody. He saved the day that
day. And then, the only thing I kind of would probably think that maybe in the future you guys would want to look at a little bit more would be something with the brakes. The brake setup you have, it works, but, I believe it would work a little bit better with maybe a little bit different rotor design and maybe doing something with a hydraulic, setup as well.
That was the original plan. Budget constraints.
Yeah, I know. Sometimes it happens.
Yeah.
It's one thing I'm just kind of just out of nowhere I thought about this. I would do something with this bracket with a gusset to keep it from twisting.
Mm.
Okay.
I want to say we meant to do one.
Yeah, because I didn't even notice that until just now that it's just literally just sitting there between the two rails. There's nothing to keep it from twisting back and forth.
Okay. Again, 2.0.
Yeah.
We got a lot to work with.
I think you guys should make a couple of these and do go-kart races.
How about coming down to the shop?
Let's bring it down to the shop. We'll put it down on the dyno. We'll really get this one tuned up and get it going. We can open up a bottle of nitrous in front of the intake and see what kind of power it can really make.
I like it.
I would just want to see Dave's face if we actually were to put nitrous on it and have him go down the road and hit the button and just eyes all big. He looked like a rat fink. you know.
We're going to need to implement the helmet policy.
So. Yeah, you definitely. I would definitely be wearing a helmet for that.
Great. Well, Brad, thank you
for
coming.
Thank you.
Appreciate you coming down, giving your 2 cents. And guys, if you haven't seen the build, be sure to check it out on YouTube, subscribe. And for more information on the tools we used to build the go-kart, visit eastwood.com.